Although the Clone Wars were over, some people never seemed to get the message. The worst case of denial was Gizor Delso, a Geonosian separatist who'd somehow escaped Lord Vader's efforts to wipe out the remnants of the CIS. Lord Vader tracked him to Mustafar and brought us in to finish the job. It seemed like a simple enough mission. But when we saw the fleet of droid ships hovering over the planet, we suddenly realized that Delso's denial mechanisms were a little more dangerous than we'd imagined.
Sir, the droids have landed on our ship. We can't launch our fighters.
Calm down, pilot. Get out there and destroy that transport. Use any means necessary to clear the hangar.
Now hear this. All hands, man your battle station. Now hear this. All hands, man your battle station. Now hear this. All hands, man your battle station. We are under attack. This is not a drill. We are under attack. This is not a drill. We are under attack. This is not a drill.
Your fighters and give those droids all you've got. Destroy their fighters and bombers. Watch out for the asteroids, pilots. They're easy to destroy, but that doesn't mean they aren't dangerous.
Scramble reinforcements. Repeat. Scramble all reinforcements.
Target that bomber.
Engineers, report to the hangar area.
Attack that bomber. He's trying to make the rest of us look bad. done, Lieutenant.
Attention all pilots. Attention all pilots. Prepare for takeoff.
Take that bomber.
Attack their shields. Use a bomber to deliver the maximum damage.
Now hear this. All hands, man your battle station.
I can't shake them.
You're trying to make the rest of us look bad.
Vader's just issued a new order. He wants someone to land in the enemy's hangar, steal one of their strike bombers, and return it to our hangar. Get moving, pilots.
Bomber, on your tail!
Attention in the hangar. Scramble all reinforcements. Roger, roger.
Report to the hangar area.
Excellent job, pilots. Lord Vader will be most pleased.
The slight whiff of nostalgia the 501st had enjoyed fighting the droid fleet over Mustafar, already grown sour by the time we'd established orbital positions. Now it was time to find out what this was all about. By the time we'd made our way to the molten surface of Mustafar, it was apparent that Delso had been a busy little bug. All by his lonesome, he'd found a previously hidden droid factory, fired it up and cranked out his own private army of battle droids. Needless to say, this got the men of the 501st a little hot under the helmet, and not just because of all that lava. Truth be told, we'd all had our fill of those gearheads during the war, and we couldn't stomach the thought of going through another one. So we blew them up. Blew up the droids, blew up the factory. Damn near blew up the planet.
All right, troops. Today we stamp out final remnants of the CIS. Eventually we'll be blowing up a hidden droid factory. But for now, we need to infiltrate and secure that nearby mining facility. Move them out. Take control. Control of the walkway.
Watch out for snipers!
Keep moving!
Sniper spotted at 2 o'clock.
That collection base looks like a good place to make a stand. Capture it! Any droid we don't destroy today will come back to haunt us tomorrow. Wipe them out! These Geonosians have been working on a new Confederate infantry prototype. Destroy the schematics before they can use them to build a new droid army.
Good shot!
Kill bringing the other beacon. Go out and retrieve it. Back to the collection base and watch the fireworks.
Target the super battle droid. It's raining bugs.
Kill them all.
Watch out for bugs.
Gaizor Delso has been defeated. Scratch one droid rebellion.
Watch your flank. It's easy when they're stupid.
The destruction of the mining facility put an end to any thoughts of a second droid rebellion. For the first time in years, the men of the 501st could relax and get about the business of maintaining an empire, rather than building one.
Thank you.
Officially, there never was a clone rebellion on Kamino. Unofficially, approximately 20 years after we were created, a special detachment of the Imperial 501st Legion was dispatched to Kamino with orders to eradicate an army of clones that had been bred to take arms against the Empire. Our mission commander, an expert on the inner workings of Kamino, was a young bounty hunter named Boba Fett.
Idea, let's get this over with.
Boba Fett has been chosen to lead a small task force into the Kamino Cloning Center. His familiarity with the center's layout and access codes should give us the element of surprise. Before we leave, the Empire wants us to collect some DNA samples from our evil brothers. Get that sample back to ship immediately. DNA sample secure. Pulling ship back to a safe distance. Good job. Now take that CP and await further orders. Your objectives. Destroy the computers keeping the Kaminoans' clone pods alive before they can create any more traitorous anti-troopers.
Is that all you've got?
flank us.
Kaminoans are evacuating in 5 minutes. Take down their transports before they can escape.
I'm done. When do I get paid?
The bounty hunter left after the battle was over. He said something about tracking down a smuggler on Tatooine. After the Kamino uprising, the Emperor decided that an army of genetically identical soldiers was too susceptible to corruption. Future troopers would be cloned from a variety of templates. Though the 501st itself remained pure, the rest of the Imperial Army gradually became more and more diverse. We never really got used to the new guys.